But what about the wife? What about the woman? Well, the Prophet ﷺ told us what to choose in a man for our daughters or our sisters. So the Prophet said ﷺ that when a woman wants to choose a man, he has to be, first thing, religious. He has to be practicing. And not every bearded brother is a practicing brother. Not Fidel Castro is not practicing. Not everyone with short thobe is a practicing brother. How do I know? Ya akhi, deal with him. If I see a brother with a long beard and a short thobe, but he lies, or he backbites, or he cheats, or he is useless, and he envies people, he looks down at people, he thinks of himself as the best man ever to walk the earth, is he a practicing brother? No, he's not. So choose someone who's practicing. How do you know? Akhi, visit the masjid next door. If someone proposes to your daughter and he looks practicing, where do you live? I live near Green Lane. Okay, we go to the sheikh who prays Zallah Khair Fajr. Do you know this brother? No. This is how he looks. I've never seen the brother. Is he practicing? He doesn't pray Fajr. What kind of a practicing brother is he? Sheikh, I always find it difficult to wake up for Fajr. Okay, well, what Isha? Sheikh, Isha is too late. So what do you pray? Asr usually, because Zuhr, I can't pray it in the masjid, at work. What kind of a Muslim is this? This is not practicing. You need someone who is fully practicing, not only in his religious commitment, but also in his character. And that is why the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said that whenever someone proposes to your wife, okay, if someone proposes to your sister, to your daughter, who his religious commitment and his character you approve of, you should give him in marriage. So it's not only religious commitment, also his character. What do we mean by character? He should be brave. He should be generous. The worst thing a sister could do is marrying a stingy person, a miserly person, who doesn't pay until you take a pint of his blood. This is difficult. Life is horrible. And this is why when one of the female companions came to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam and said, Muawiyah bin Sufyan and Abu Jahm both proposed to me. So he said, Muawiyah is su'luk. He doesn't have a penny. He's poor by nature. And Abu Jahm, he batters women. He abuses women. But marry Osama bin Zayd ibn Haritha, may Allah be pleased upon them all. So he has to be, his character has to be accepted in the sense that he has to be generous. He has to be tolerant. Never ever marry someone who has rage attacks. Never. It's the worst person. And I get a lot of these problems of men. They confuse themselves with an AK-47, with a Kalashnikov. When they're angry, talik, 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 talik. And your mother and your sister and your aunts, they're all talik. He divorces everybody. He sees, what is this? And then after 5 minutes, Sheikh, I made a mistake. What did you do? I gave my wife talaq 17 times. Wallahi, akhi, three's on the house and the rest is on you. What is this? No, you don't want to marry someone. You don't want to give your sister, you don't want to give your daughter to someone who gets angry quickly and is impulsive and may do something that he may regret later on. He has to be tolerant. He has to be among those who look the other way. He shouldn't be an auditor. Because if you give your sister to an auditor, every time say, how much did you spend? Where is the rest? Where was this thing? Why don't you put it there? He's gonna make life hell for her. No, you want to choose someone who looks the other way. Even if she does a mistake or two, he pretends that he did not see anything and life beautifully goes on. He has to be as mentioned in the Quran, إِنَّ خَيْرَ مَنِ اسْتَأْجَرْتَ الْقَوِيِّ الْأَمِينَ. He has to be strong and he has to be honest, trustworthy. Because you are entrusting him with your honor, with your flesh. You're entrusting him with your daughter or with your sister. So don't throw them away to anyone who comes and asks for them. He has to be secretive in the sense that he does not spread the secrets of the house. Not that he has relationships and he's secretive. No, he has to be modest in the sense that I've sat with men, quote unquote, so-called men, who say what happens with them in bed. My, I did this with my wife. Oh, that was fun. But the other thing wasn't. And I say, Akhi, this is the worst thing a man can do. Yes, it's okay. It's man talk. It's not man talk. It's animal talk. Men with dignity and honor refuse to go down this road. He has to be, you have to look for someone who is fair and just. And these two things, fairness and justice, if a man has them, wallahi, you give your daughter to him and fear nothing. And that is why Al-Hasan, may Allah have mercy on his soul, said, give your daughter or your sister to one who is fearing Allah Azza wa Jal. Because if he loves her, he will honor her. And if he hates her, he would not do her wrong. If I hate my wife, I will not be unfair or unjust because I fear Allah. If I do anything wrong, even if I hate her guts, even if she is ugly and smelly, not I'm saying that she is, but even if she's like this, I will not do her wrong because I fear Allah Azza wa Jal, and I fear that Allah may send me someone to mistreat my daughters, my sisters, my cousins in the same fashion. That is why I fear Allah. I try to be as good as possible. Try to choose someone who dresses well and who has a good scent and smell. Not necessarily wearing Versace or Gucci, but someone who looks presentable and who smells normal. Because this will be with you till the end of time. A lot of the sisters send me emails and complaints of the smell of the brothers' mouths. They don't floss, they don't wash their mouths. The Prophet ﷺ, the first thing he used to do when he enters the house was to use the miswak to clean his mouth. Ibn Abbas, may Allah be pleased with him, he used to take real good care of himself. And whenever his companions talked to him, he said, as I want my wife to look good, I like to look good for her. So it's a two-way road. Try to choose someone who would honor your family, who would respect your father and mother, and don't take a gangster who would maybe kill them in the following day. Choose someone who would respect them, who would give them the necessary honor. And try to get someone who is jealous. Do not get a man who is not jealous, because this is not a man. The first thing that stands out in a man is his jealousy. And the first thing that stands out in a woman is her feminine side and her vulnerability. And the more he's jealous and strong and she's weak and vulnerable, they can have a good relationship. But when the woman becomes a man and the man becomes a sissy, with all due respect, this is not a marriage. Seriously, most of marriages do not continue because of this. Because you have a man in woman's clothing and you have something else in the man's shoes.